The following is an excerpt of a recent power-up webinar taking a look at third-party plugins for Final Cut Pro 10. The next plugin I want to showcase is called Photo Montage. It's published by Noise Industries. It's a $199 plugin that animates still images to create a variety of slideshows. Keep in mind this does not animate video clips, only stills, but it does contain more than 100 presets and it requires that FX Factory be installed on your system. Photo Montage is a generator, so let's light up the generators and go down to Photo Montage. And here we have 20 broad categories of effects that we could use. Let's go all the way down to the bottom and select Whoosh. I'll just drag Whoosh over to the timeline. It says what format you're going to use. I'm going to say 720p. I'm going to leave the resolution the same. Normally, I work at faster frame rates, but just because I want to save time today, we'll leave it at 23.98. Click OK. There is our generator. I could work with the on-screen controls, but I find it's more reliable to work in the inspector. So I'll turn the inspector on, select the generator, and the very first thing that we get to do is to choose the preset. We already said whooshes, but within whooshes, we have all these different categories that we can use. I'm going to pick something, neat fly-through will be a good one. So that's the format of whooshing we're going to do. But now we need to set the images themselves, so click Choose. Remember that Photo Montage only works with still images, so I'm going to Command-click here and select five of these, and click Open. This opens the Edit Image Browser. If I want the berries to occur before the bench, click, hold, and drag and change the stacking order. If I want each slide to have a different name, for instance here, we'll call this Mountain River, and we'll call these Wild Berries, and we'll call this the Lonely, click on it so it highlights, there we go, Lonely Bench. Boom. If we wanted each image to have its own separate time, we could change the time here by clicking on it, but I'm going to give them all a universal time. We can also have its scale, change its size. And this is spatial conform, except it appears in the menu. All these are 16 by 9, so I'm going to just leave them alone. Once you're done making these initial changes, click OK. The next thing that we get to do is we get to make a few setting changes. How long do we want the images to run? I'm going to have them all run 2.5 seconds. How long do we want the duration? I want it to be a second long. What kind of ease in and ease out? Linear means there's no ease in, no ease out, and these give us a wide range of gentle to really exaggerated acceleration and deceleration. Just pick the one that works the best for you. I'm going to leave this set to the default. We can then configure the whoosh and say, where is it going from? Left to right, right to left, top to bottom. We could do all of that. I'm going to leave that alone. Geometry is how we want the images to fit on the page. I'm going to leave that alone. Border, do we want to have a border? If so, how big a border and what color border? Let's just add a white border and make it look like it's a bordered photograph. We could add rounded corners if we want. Like I said, there's lots to choose from. Do we want to vignette this? That would be no. So we're going to leave that off. Do we want to use a different background? Do we want a drop shadow? The answer is yes. Now, the drop shadow is on by default, but the offsets are very small. So I'm going to just increase the X offset, increase the Y offset, and increase the shadow radius, and increase the opacity to make it darker so we can see what's going on. Pull the radius back a bit. Pull the Y down. There we go. Now we've got a good shadow. Again, season to your own taste. We can add, this is cool. Watch this. I'm going to add titles. Turn the titles on. And there's our Wild Berries title. And we can add a title drop shadow. And we'll make this bold so we can actually read it. Okay, with that being said, let's play it, see what happens. Try and play it at least. Needs rendering. In fact, let's just render it. Select our clip, modify, render selection. Rendering is just a bit longer than real time. It's now completed. Let's play it and see what happens. And let's change the position of our font so that it goes to relative to the image. There we go. Try it again and render. Now, we could absolutely do this ourselves, but it would take a whole lot longer. The benefit to using the plugin is it gives us a really cool look and saves us time. Let's delete this. There's one other that I want to show you. Let's do accordion. We'll just drag that over. And again, we'll set it to 720p. Highlight it. We're going to choose a collapse preset. Pick our images. And hold the command key down and just select the ones that we want. We could change the order. We've seen it. We could change the name. We've seen how to do that. And, oh, watch this. If I go back to the browser, and let's add a background from generators. Let's add retro. Notice that now I've added my own background to those. So now that we've added our own images, let's take a look at what it looks like. Our images, our background, their animation saves me a ton of time. The plugin is called Photo Montage from Noise Industries. This has been an excerpt of a recent power-up webinar taking a look at third-party plugins for Final Cut Pro 10. For the complete version of this online training, please visit our store at larryjordan.biz/store and look for Webinar 119. By the way, if you need to stretch your training dollars, a subscription membership to our video training library saves you money. You can access all of our videos for a low monthly price of only $19.99. That's more than 700 movies, dozens of hours of training, all in-depth and all up-to-date. Plus, members can attend all of our power-up webinars for free. Our training covers Adobe and Apple software. We update it every week. And for more information, visit larryjordan.biz/subscriptions. And thanks.